Okay, we're recording.
So always end in a question.
Always end in a question. Why?
To keep control of the conversation.
Exactly. You lead the conversation by the way you ask questions. You are the doctor in the room, but it's how you ask questions. You have to blend them with redirection and stroking and nurturing. Okay. So if I ask you a question, well, do people really make this quick a decision on real estate like this?
Yeah, many of them do, Claude.
Good question. Glad you brought it up. Always reinforce.
Okay. Great question, Claude. I get this all the time. And yes, many of the people that I work with, they do make a decision pretty quick. It sounds like you don't really want to make one today.
This is a little fast for me. I'm just a little nervous. We just met. This is our first phone call and everything. I just don't know what to do right now.
How do I respond to that?
Okay, turn it around. You say the same thing. I'll do it for you.
Okay. I'm not sure if I'm comfortable making a decision.
You know what? Good for you. If I was in your position, I'd feel the same way. But we're talking today because you have a problem. You're trying to buy a home, sell a home, invest in a home. I don't know the situation. Okay. And this is the problem. And I have a viable solution for you. But if you're not comfortable with it, let's just say it's over. It is over, isn't it? It's okay to say no. I've got so many other people to call. Don't worry about it. Somebody else is going to make a lot of money today or get a nice home or get a nice investment property or get their home sold for the top sales price. But it's not going to be you today. Maybe never. That's okay.
Okay. Well, hold on. I just need to talk to my wife.
Let me check with my, that's a good point. Let me check with my wife. Hey, honey, is it okay to do business with Mr. Young and save his family and get him into a good home and help him make money?
Yeah, Wes is a good guy.
Yeah, my wife said Wes is a good guy. She said, just do it. So can you call your wife or is she in the home? And can you get back to me in the next 30 minutes or so? I can take this off the market. I can stop my phone calls so that I can hold this for you, but I can't hold it for all day or days. I can't do that. It's the market is just too hot, Wes.
Yeah, can you give me 30 minutes to make a phone call?
I'll give you 30 minutes. Call your wife, discuss it with her. If you want to bring her back on a Zoom call, I'll be glad to answer all your questions. And you can still say no to me. Don't worry. We're still friends. Okay. But this is you know what's the difference between success and failure? Waking up and being 65 and eating dog food. It's about missed opportunities in life. You're how old, sir?
32.
Can you 32? Imagine if you bought a home when you were 20, when you were 22. How much money would you have now? $250,000, sir. In paid down principal and an appreciation and a tax benefit, you would have a core $250,000 to your name now at 32 years old. What do you think will happen when you're 42 or 52?
It'll double.
Life is about missed opportunities, sir. Would you like to miss another one or move forward in 30 minutes?
Okay, I got it.
Okay, off the role play.
So redirect.
I am doing a mind, you know what? I mean, I am playing with your psychology, with your mind, right, your subconscious, right. Your emotions, everything. What have I created by just using the right words the right way? I'm not fighting with you. Did I argue with you? You're right, sir. I know how you feel. I would do the exact same thing.
You're cut out for a second.
I said, did you notice I was never fighting with you or arguing with
right.
you?
Right.
Okay.
Right. I don't know if I could do it. You said, yeah, hey, that's right. It's okay.
It's okay. Don't worry about it. And then I use scarcity and social proof. Let's talk about that for a minute. Social proof. You see, your favorite NCAA March Madness basketball player wears a great pair of Nikes. What's the shoe you want to wear?
We'll do Nike.
Yeah. Well, that's why they pay people tremendous amounts of money, because if a celebrity is wearing it, the football player, the basketball, whatever, if they're wearing it, then I should get it too. Because if it works for them, it'll work for me. That's a celebrity endorsement. That's kind of social proof. You go to a restaurant, you go past Popeye's chicken and the line is 100 people deep. What goes through your mind? Maybe you don't even like chicken.
Yeah, maybe I should get some.
Yeah. Why? What's going on inside your body when you see that line?
Everybody else is getting it, so I think I should get it.
Exactly. Shit, what do they know that I don't know? They must be right and I'm wrong. I gotta learn to like chicken, you know, or something like that. Okay, that's social proof. So when I go to you, sir, don't worry about it. I got 20 other people. Someone's going to make a lot of money today. Unfortunately, it's not you. Maybe in 10, 20 years, you'll figure this out. Okay, which is kind of a little shot, you know. The thing about it is that's social.
So you say, don't worry about it. So you kind of, you agree with their negative thoughts and then add scarcity or social proof.
Yep. And what's going through your head?
So, I'm not really comfortable. You say, oh, that's okay.
What's the amateur sales guy do, Wes? When he gets a stall or, oh, no, let me tell you, you're wrong. Let me tell you all about this. And we've been in business for 30 years and this has got great opportunity for
right.
You know, and they argue with you, don't they?
Yeah.
And when when someone argues with you, do they bring you in closer to want to do business, or do they push you further out because your guard is up now?
Push you further away.
Yeah. That's okay. And then scarcity. Okay. Sir, we only have this one. Don't worry about it. Usually when people tell me they want to think about it, they're really saying no. They're being polite because they know how sensitive I am. Okay. Why don't we just, if you can't say it, so when I say you're not allowed to think about it, I don't mean that as nasty as it sounds. I just mean, let's let it go because I can do this with somebody else. I don't have to pressure you, sir. You either see the benefit of the opportunity. It's not the money though, is it? It's always the money. It's always the money, by the way.
So that should be a question that's always asked if they stall. It's not the money, is it?
It's not the money, right?
Okay.
When should we talk about money? In the beginning? We talked about this yesterday in the group call. You know, when I held up the 3-minute timer. I don't know if you were watching that part. Should you talk about money in the beginning, the middle, or the end of a conversation?
The beginning.
Right. What do most salespeople do? When do they talk about the money?
Wait to the end.
At the end. And then the guy says, hey, I'm broke. Well, shit, we ain't going to do anything. Over. But you just wasted 45 minutes of God-given life. Talk about the money up front. Okay. Sir, let me ask you something. You want to buy a home. You want to get an investment property. You want to make some money. Can we talk? You mind if we talk about money for a second? Is that all right? Are you comfortable with that? Is that all right?
Yeah, that's okay.
Thank you very
much. I really don't. I'm really on a strict budget though. So
okay.
Then
maybe you shouldn't be looking at buying your home or investing in a home. Maybe you should just stay in your mother-in-law's attic with your girlfriend and your chihuahuas.
Well, we really need a new house, and you know, I'm really trying to make the numbers work.
I'm confused. When you say make the numbers work, help me out. What does that mean?
We just have a very strict budget that, you know, I mean, the most we can really spend is probably like
budget means,
probably like 100,000.
You have 100,000 in savings or you want to buy something for 100,000? I'm confused.
We want to buy something for 100,000.
Oh, okay. I can get your cardboard box behind the Piggly Wiggly. North County Fair.
Well, I mean, that's really what we got to work with. I mean, yeah. I don't want to take out any more loans.
Oh, okay. Well, yeah, why? What's wrong with a loan?
I just don't feel comfortable. You know, we just finished paying off all these loans and, you know, got ourselves out of debt. So, you know, we don't want to go back into it.
Okay. Then maybe you should just stay renting, you know, for another 10, 20, 30 years.
But we really need this house.
I can't help you, sir. You're handcuffing me. I'm trying to help you. You don't want to do a loan. You want to get a property in a $300,000 neighborhood for $100,000. I can't do business with you. It's over. You're fired.
Well, it sounds like it's not going to work.
It's not. It wouldn't, sir. It'll never work. You know why? Before I go.
Why is that?
Your expectations are not dealing with reality. Don't get mad at me, please don't. Please don't. People get mad at me because I get this from my mother. I like to speak my mind.
I mean, but these prices, I mean, $100,000 could get a really good house, right?
No.
Well, then
You want me to lie to you or tell you the truth? Yeah, you can get I can get you a McMansion. I can get you an 8,000 square foot home with a marble lined swimming pool and a view of the ocean.
Yeah.
You know what I can help you?
Yeah.
You know what I can do?
Business today.
I might be able to get you into a small condo loft, a starter home.
Okay.
And you'd need at least $10,000 down and $125,000 to $150,000 loan. Can we do that or is it over?
$10,000 down with $150,000 loan. I may have to talk with my wife about that one.
Okay. And you're newlyweds or you've been married a while?
Newlyweds.
Okay, good. And you've never had these discussions before?
No, not about something this big.
Okay. Can you get back to me before 2:30 today?
Yeah, I can do that.
Thank you. And it's okay to say no. I mean, I know I threw a lot at you and I was a little abrasive, but it's only because I need to tell you that I like to tell people the truth. You don't want, I mean, there's plenty of people who bullshit you out there. Would you like the truth?
Yeah.
I like helping people. You seem like a decent young man, a hard worker and everything. I got to tell you the truth. And anything, let me put it to you this way, sir. Imagine we get you into that condo today. We get it for $125,000 to $150,000. In 4 or 5 years, it's worth $200,000, $250,000. You've made yourself $50,000 to $100,000 equity and paid down the principal. You got some of your income back because now you can deduct the mortgage interest. And then we can trade up to another home, a larger home, because now you have equity. You have FU money to put down, real money.
I like the sound of that.
Which means?
This may be something we can do. Let me get back to you at 2:30.
I'll talk to you then. I'm going to change my schedule. I do have an appointment at 2:30, but I'm going to cancel it and move it because you're going to call me exactly at 2:30, aren't you?
Yes.
What?
Yeah. I'll call you at 2:30.
Okay. Off the role play. Everything I'm doing, you're going to listen to this recording. Everything I just did was for a reason. I'm using all the different aspects of psychological warfare and suggestion on you. Okay. I get a lot of people. That was a great role play, by the way. Super role play. Nice going. Because I get people like that. They want to buy, you know, they want to get a house for nothing down with no credit and no money. Am I going to waste? How much time can I waste with that person?
Right. Yeah. Zero.
Zero. There's plenty of people out there who have money, who have the maturity, who have who are working a regular job, who have the credit, but who need help. You want to be the doctor out there. And to be a good doctor, you've got to be assertive. Because prospects are very manipulative, aren't they?
Yeah, they are.
They're very good at what they do.
Okay.
They're
so when it comes to marketing or like getting lead generation, what should I be doing to get leads?
You can, like, I've done texting before. What did I tell you? Go ahead. I'm sorry.
I'll say I've done texting before.
Does it work? It works great, doesn't it? You got all the leads you needed.
Yeah, I mean, it kind of filtered out the cold calls, and you just got the people who were interested in selling. So it kind of cut out the cold calls.
Okay, so you had so it worked really well. You had people to call, and you got deals, right?
Some deals, yeah.
But why not keep just, if it's working, why not keep doing it?
That's a good question.
Because it's not.
Yeah, well, it's just like you put so much money into it, and you may get one to 10 out of all that you send out. Mm-hmm. And then, you know, they're asking for ridiculous prices and all this stuff. And then you kind of just like, okay.
Mm-hmm. So you're.
So the marketing costs.
Yeah. And so you're spending money to get a lot of leads, and out of those 1,000 leads, maybe one or two prospects. And then out of those one or two prospects, they're so unmotivated that there's nothing there. So time, money, frustration. Is that the way you want to do marketing?
No, not at all.
Okay. That's my point. That's what everybody else does. Okay. And it's a numbers game. I know, but man, I don't like those numbers. That math does not work for me. That's garbage math. Okay. So you can call people, you can pay for leads, but they're low quality. You can call leads that are on the existing market, the multiple listing system, the MLS, the Craigslist. You can use Zoom, Zillow, Trulia, all the different public forums, and you can search for sale or for rent by owner, which, by the way, is not the worst. It's not bad. It goes back to my premise. Okay. You got to speak to people every day, make offers every day. And while you're doing stuff that's on the open market, can you also do what I do, attraction marketing? Can you get people calling you? Can you attract the moth to the flame? Do you know what I mean by that?
Yes and no.
Which one? You pick. Like this recording. We're doing this recording. I'm going to send you the audio and the video. What could you do with this great role play, this great recording? What could you do with it in terms of marketing?
Put it on YouTube.
Yeah.
Put it on YouTube.
Yeah. Could you put it on? Could you edit it a little? Use QuickTime. Do you have QuickTime? You have a Mac computer? Yeah. Use QuickTime. You can trim it. You take out the role play we just did and then add a recording. You can edit into it. Real easy. You don't have to be a Photoshop expert or anything for this. This is real easy. This is like finger painting. In terms of technology, it's that easy. And then you say, hi, my name's Wes Young. I solve problems in real estate. You're looking to buy, sell, invest. You got a problem in real estate? Call me. I answer my own phone, 123-4567. I have a webpage, wesyoung.com. I solve problems in real estate. Call me up with your deal. Maybe we'll partner. Maybe I'll refer you to somebody who'll want to do the deal with you. I have solutions for you. It won't cost you anything. I answer my own phone, 123-4567, boom. And you put in your commercial or you offer an incentive, free consultation, a free this or that. And you do this on a regular basis. I did one yesterday.
Okay.
Okay. Did you see the one I did yesterday? How to fire the prospect.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Today, I have a new, right after you, I have a brand new prospect who set up an appointment with me.
Okay.
Right here. Him and his wife. Okay. Right here. Oh, brother and sister. Excuse me. And they set up with me. They're my next phone call. Matter of fact.
Okay.
What do you think I'm going to, what's the first thing you're going to, somebody contacts you through attraction marketing. They saw your videos. And you meet with them on Zoom or the phone. Isn't that okay. Doesn't that take the stress? Isn't that just a a really nice chill conversation.
Yeah, because they called you. Yeah.
Ring, ring. Hi, Mr. Young. Joe and Mary Blow here.
How you doing, Joe?
Thanks. I love your video. I love your video, man. That video you did with Claude Diamond. That was awesome. I loved it.
Thank you. Yeah, it was a good time.
So
what made you set an appointment?
I wanted to ask you a few questions if you have time. I really appreciate it. Thank you. We're looking, we need to get into a home. We have some cash, but we're coming out of a bankruptcy from 5 years ago, but we do have some cash down and we're both working. Is there a way we can get into a home?
Potentially. Well, what exactly are you looking for?
Anything to start. We're living in my mother-in-law's basement right now. It's real damp and cold and everything. And we just want our own place, rather than rent another place.
Okay. Well, let me ask you this. How much money are you working with?
Finally. Okay. Finally. Should have done that 30 seconds ago.
Right.
Okay. And soften it up a little. Soften it up. You said you have money saved.
Okay. You said you had some money saved up. Can you tell me how much you got?
Use
how much you're working with?
Would you be comfortable sharing that with me so I can help you?
Okay.
Round numbers. Are we talking about 25, 50, 100, 300? How much? What are we talking about here?
Okay. We're looking at like 300.
Okay, 300,000, and your neighborhood's around 600,000, right? Southern, in that area?
Yeah.
Okay. I think I can help you there. I have a boom. Then you go into that.
Gotcha. Okay. Assuming that I have inventory like that?
Or what if you don't have inventory? Can you put a deal together and go to somebody and say they have 300,000, they both are working, but they got this bankruptcy, so they can't get a mortgage, but they have 300,000 to put down. Okay. Can you call up a seller and say, how would you like to get full price in 300,000 today? Do I have your attention, sir?
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Yeah, you do. You said 300,000.
Yeah, sell me. Go ahead. Let's figure you got the...
Oh, I'm calling.
These,
okay.
Let's see you figure these, got these folks. They like you. You got a meeting of the minds. Now you're calling up, you're calling up properties in the neighborhood. Okay. Are calling up realtors, and you got a client with 300,000 and you're calling up on $500,000-$700,000 homes. So you're looking for an owner finance type of situation.
Okay.
So you get, so you got me on the phone, Joe Blow. Hi, Joe Blow with a home to sell.
Hey Joe, are you interested in financing a home? I got a client here with 300,000. They're looking to move quick. They just, they got some issues on their credit, with some bankruptcy stuff, and they're looking for a make a home.
Who are you? And 300,000. Why don't they just get a loan?
Oh, they had some credit issues, but I mean, they got the cash ready to go. They're looking to move quick. I'm sorry. My name is Wes Young. I buy and sell houses, and I'm a real estate investor here in the area.
I'm the doctor. I'm the doctor of real estate. I want you to play a role. What does a millionaire sound? What does a millionaire sound like?
Like no worries.
My shit don't stink, baby.
Right.
Okay. You got a million.
Hey, I'm
got
here to a million solve, dollars. Here to solve your problem.
You got $1 million in your pocket. It's in the glove compartment of your car right now. $1 million. Okay.
Okay.
What's $1 million? $1,000? I think so.
Okay, got it. Okay, hey, my name is my name is Wes Young. I'm a real estate investor here in the area.
You're one of those guys, huh?
One of those guys. I've had that like, oh, you're, what do you say to that?
You say, you're right, sir. Go ahead. Throw it at me. Go ahead.
Okay.
Give me
real estate. Are you one of Claude? You sound like one of those real estate investors.
I am a bottom feeding capitalist. I love to make money, real estate guys, but I also show other people how to make money. And I do buy business honestly and ethically. Would you, sir, if you want to attack me, that's okay. I'll put a bullseye on my back, Would you like to make three? Would you like to get full price, no 6% real estate commission, no closing costs, and get $300,000 today? Or should I leave you alone because you want to insult me instead?
That $300,000 sounds good.
Which means?
Which means we could have a deal.
Okay, sounds good. I got John and Mary. They have $300,000. It's verified. I can send you all the paperwork. They're looking for a house like yours, which is unoccupied. I can get you full price. You're asking $550,000. That's fair, and subject to a title search. And you holding the other $250,000 at 6% interest for 5 years with a balloon.
That sounds reasonable.
Great. I'll tell you what I can do. I can send you the paperwork. I can introduce you to John and Mary. I can put this. That's the good news. You ready for the bad news?
Yeah. What's the bad news?
I get $50,000 for putting this deal together.
$50,000. Who's going to pay you $50,000?
You.
How am I going to pay you $50,000?
Because you're getting $300,000, and that means $250,000 for you in cash and $50,000 for me.
That sounds like a lie. What about 30? Actually, what about 15,000?
Sorry.
Sorry, what?
I'm sorry, I can't do that. I'm getting you full price, sir, with no real estate commission and no closing costs. That's worth $50,000. Full price offer on your home. No negotiation, no closing costs. 6% on $500,000 would be $30,000 by itself.
Yeah, but that's
my standard. That's my standard fee, sir. I get. What do you think would be fair? I'd like to do business with you.
I could do 17,000.
Can't do that, sir. I got too many other people willing to do deal. You're getting 300,000 in cash up front. You're getting 6% interest on the balance of your mortgage, on the balance of your equity, on the property. If you're uncomfortable with it, I respect that. And I got plenty of other people to call, but I'd still like to do business with you. How about I come down a little, you come up? Is that fair?
I'm only asking
10% of the deal for putting this all together.
Sure. What are you talking?
50,000.
You said you were coming down.
Okay. What do you think? I'll come down. I'll tell you what, I'll come down to 45. If we can make a commitment and do a deal today.
45, can I pay you half now, half later?
When you say later, what do you mean?
How soon can this deal get wrapped up?
How's April 30th?
Yeah, I could give you half now and the rest at April 30th. Can you do that?
Yeah. Sounds like a deal. You got a deal, sir. Good for you. You're a good negotiator. I respect that. I'll send you the paper. Go ahead.
I was gonna say 25,000.
You didn't though, did you? And you know what? If you said 25, I would have negotiated 37,500, and you would have saved yourself another $8,000, $8,500. But you didn't. You didn't. Why didn't you? The word you said in the beginning when we had our conversation, what's the one thing holding everyone back from negotiating just like you're doing right now?
What's the one thing? In my head, I was like, well, I can't say 25,000, but I was like, well.
It can't hurt to ask, right? It can't hurt to ask. Good role play, man. What'd you learn from all that?
I always think that, I guess I wasn't thinking that you had to, like if somebody called me like, hey, we got some money, we were looking to buy a house, I guess my thought process be like, well, dang, I don't have any inventory, so maybe I can't help them versus, well, let me just call some people.
It depends on, is the clock ticking? Is there a lot of inventory? Is there no inventory? These are all parts of how you negotiate. If you've got a contract and it expires in 5 days, am I going to take 15,000 instead of 50? You better believe it, because 15,000 is better than 100% of nothing, right?
Right.
Okay. It depends on the conditions, on all the factors when you're negotiating. Bottom line, is there anything wrong with making $15,000 on a Thursday morning?
No, not at all.
No, it's all right. Honey, right. We're going out tonight. You know, boom. It's okay. So this is what you've just done is you found a deal, you negotiated a deal, got a commitment, you used different psychological aspects, and then you went and you remarketed it and you made money as a principal on the transaction or as a consultant. Nice going.
So in the contract,
that's what you have to do. And we have to leave in a minute. I have to go to my next appointment.
Okay.